In this lecture, we are going to cover the topics such as the overview of different modes of transport, means by which modes the transportation activities can be conducted. We will be learning certain aspects about and types about land transport, then about the water transport and the types of air transport. We will be learning certain aspects, types of various modes of transport and how they are used. What are their evolution criteria? Let us learn about modes of transport first. So, in general, the modes of transport can be divided into three categories: land transport, water transport, and air transport. This air transport can be divided into four categories: pathways, roadways, tramways, and railways. Waterways can be divided into two categories: inland waterways and ocean waterways. And air transport can also be divided into two categories, which are passenger transport and cargo transport. Now, the pathways are divided into two categories: headlocks and pack animals. Roadways can be divided into two categories: vehicular roadways and non-vehicular roadways. And the railways are divided into two categories: passenger trains and good or freight trains. Now, the inland waterways or inland water transport can be divided into canal transport and river transport. The ocean transport can be divided into coastal shipping and overseas shipping. And this overseas shipping can be divided into liners, tramps, and tankers. So, one by one, we will learn all the things about land transport, water transport, and air transport, and in which we will try to cover all these mentioned criteria, all the definitions, all the terminologies and importance of all kind of criteria. So let us begin. First of all, we will try to learn about land transport. So as I have mentioned in earlier slides, that the land transport is divided into four categories. First is pathways. Let us learn about pathways first. But before going into detail, let me tell you that this general classification of transport, this classification, this transport classification is done on the basis of the way, type of vehicle, type of motive power, and terminals. So, the classification you are observing over here is done on the basis of the way, vehicle, motive power, and terminals. Let us learn about land transport and pathways. Now, what are these pathways? How can we understand the concept of pathways? These pathways are categorized into two parts: headloads and pack animals. So let me tell you in detail that these pathways are normally called as streets. We all have heard about this word, streets, or I should say narrow streets. They are mainly found in the remote villages, forest areas, and hilly areas. The pathways can be divided into two parts: headloads and pack animals. Now, what is the meaning of headloads? Headloads means where the human transport is possible. It is used in the hilly areas where animals cannot reach, but humans can reach. So, those are the means of transport. They are called as pathways. And the pack animals, they are also called as animal transport. They are used in backward areas. And in the pack animal or pack transport, the animals like horse, pony, donkey, buffaloes, camel, elephant, yak, sheep, all these kind of these animals are used for this purpose. So, pathways are used in the remote villages, forest area, and hilly areas. They are the important part of transportation in these areas. They are divided into two parts: Head loads means human transport where animals cannot reach, and second is the pack animals, means the animal transport where the animals like horse, pony, donkey are used. So this was the first criteria. Now let us learn about the second category, which is roadways. Roadways can be further divided into vehicular transport and non-vehicular transport. Now, road transport is one of the most important modes of transport. The history of road transport started from ancient civilizations. And we all know that gradually it becomes more and more popular means of transport. It can be divided into two parts. Vehicular transport means the transport in which vehicles are used, and non-vehicular transport means the transport in which vehicles are not used. So, the vehicular transport involves modes like cars, trucks, buses, lorries, rickshaws, bullock carts, tangas, hand carts, etc. And the non-vehicular, in which the vehicles are not used, this transport means include animals like cats, dogs, elephants, etc. So this was the brief about roadways. Now let us learn about the third criteria, which is tramways. Majority in India, the tramways are observed in cities like Kolkata and Bangalore. They are like this kind of system in which the tracks are provided, and this particular mode of transport is known as trams. It is one of the most cheaper, longer, quicker, and safer mode of transport. It is suitable for large cities, but it is also having certain limitations, such as it can move in slow pace, slow speed. It requires huge investment. It is inflexible in operation. So gradually, it replaced by other means of land transport, such as vehicular transport or rail transport, etc. Currently, you can observe this tramways in Kolkata and other Indian cities. The minus points of tramways are slowness, huge investment, and inflexibility. Plus points are they are cheaper. Cheaper here, both of these things, this cheaper and huge investment, are contradictory. But whenever the trams are provided in large numbers, ultimately it becomes cheaper. If small operations of the tram transportation is provided, then huge investment is required. So this was about the tramways. Now, one of the most hot favorite transportation system, which is railway. Railway has been the pioneer of modern mechanical transport. It has brought the greatest revolution in transport. We all know that it accelerated the commercial and industrial development of various countries. Until the introduction of motor transport was done, railway had the monopoly as the land transport. In India, it is the principal means of transport. It carries over 80% of goods traffic and over, say, 70% of passenger traffic, and more than 60 kilometers of the railways are provided. So this is about the railways. There are two types of railways: passenger trains and good trains or freight trains. We all know. This is the photo of rail transport. It is the pioneer of modern mechanical transport. Until the introduction of motor transport was done, railway had the monopoly as the land transport. It carries over 80% of good traffic and 70% of passenger traffic. So this was about the land transport. Now let us understand the concept of water transport. Water transport is the cheapest and the oldest form of transport for heavy goods and bulk cargoes. They are the natural gifts because they do not require any large amount of capital expenditure for construction of road and others like railway tracks. In addition to that, the cost of running is also very less. So the water transport can be divided into two parts. First is the inland waterway and second is the ocean transport. The inland waterways can be divided into river transport and canal transport, whereas ocean transport can be divided into coastal shipping and overseas shipping. The overseas shipping can be divided into three parts: liner shipping, tramp shipping, and tank shipping. Now, the liner shipping can be divided into two parts: passenger liner and cargo liner. Let us understand the hierarchy once again. Water transport can be divided into inland and ocean. Inland can be divided into river and canal. Ocean can be divided into coast and overseas. Overseas can be divided into linear, tramp, and tank. And liner can be divided, or linear can be divided into passenger or cargo. Let us understand the concept of inland waterways. Inland waterways are divided into two parts. First is the river transport and second is the canal transport. Now we all know that rivers are the waterways which are given by nature. It is suitable for the small boats and steamers. It was highly developed before the railway tracks or evolution of railway was done. But with the development of railways, this particular river transport was neglected. And nowadays it has been obsoleted. So this is the river transport. I have already mentioned that it is the nature's gift. It has been obsoleted due to the development of railways. And if I talk about the canal transport, this canal transport is also called as channel transport. These are the artificial waterways constructed for the purpose of navigation and irrigation. So this was all about inland waterways, which was the first category of waterways. Now the another category is ocean transport. Ocean transport can be subdivided into two parts: coastal shipping and overseas shipping. Now the coastal shipping is comparatively cheaper, it is speedy, flexible, and economical form of transport for the movement of bulky and heavy cargoes. Usually, the coastal shipping trade is reserved for the national shipping. Keep mark this thing, that the coastal shipping is usually reserved for national shipping. Whereas the overseas shipping is reserved for international shipping. It is divided on the basis of working. It is divided into three parts. The liner one means, the liner overseas shipping means, it follows fixed places and fixed timetable. It is having fixed routes. The tramps means they have no set routes or fixed timetable. And the oil tanker are specially sea carriers of crude oil in very large quantity. The liners can be divided into two parts: passenger liners and cargo. Let us understand the concept once again. Coastal is used for national shipping. Overseas is used for international shipping. Liner means which is having the route and timetable fixed. Tramp means it doesn't have any routes or fixed timetable. And the tank means it is reserved for things like crude oil, large quantity crude oil. The liners can be divided into passenger liner and cargo liner. And let us understand the third concept, which is air transport. Air transport is the gift of 20th century to the world. It is the latest means of transport. Let us understand an interesting fact, that the first flight in the air was made in 1903, and it ran only for 12 seconds. Successfully, it was used as a means of transport after the First World War. The First World War was done between the year of 1914 to 1918. The air transport can again be subdivided into two parts, which is passenger and cargo. So, important points about the air transport is that it is the gift of 20th century. It is the latest means of transport. The first flight was made in 1903, which ran for 12 seconds only. And then it was normally used as the means of transport after the First World War was completed, means after 1918. It can again divide into two parts: passenger and cargo. So this was all about the means of transport. I hope you understood the concept thoroughly. We have understand the concepts that land transport can be divided into categories like pathways, roadways, trams and railways. Water transport can be divided into categories like inland waterways and ocean waterways. And air transportation can be divided into passenger and cargo. Thank you so much.